Hello and welcome to Study Introduction to Early Childhood Education. I'm Sajeevani Vandagoon, Creating an Environment for Learning, Topic 5. Learning outcomes, explain the importance of learning environment for young children, plan the physical environment and support effective learning for children. Plan lessons which enhance a child development. Plan the daily schedule for children, young children. Well, look at the introduction. The environment a child grows up in plays a very important role in his or her development. Actually, it is in this environment that their interests, triumphs, problems and concerns evolve, image and develop. An environment for children includes all the conditions that affect their surrounding and also to the people in it. These physical human qualities come together to create a space in which children and adults work and play. A good environment is a key to professionalism in working with young children. The first few years of a child's lives are crucial. In that it becomes the foundation of for the future. So therefore, a proper planning of a well thought out environment and program which include a play and various learning opportunities are very important for the early years. Let's talk about the plan in the physical environment. So one of the components with reference to the environment for early childhood education is the physical features. The physical environment is actually very important in the setting of a child care facility. The space, room management, equipment and also materials. So caring for the children encompasses creating a good environment for them to grow and thrive in. This translates to a safe and hygiene environment. With the availability of equipment and activities which are suitable for and meet the needs of the children. And also we have to consider safety and all important features at all age level, because it is a pleasant and welcoming atmosphere. It should be there, for a child to come and study. So the environment should be attractive and also should be very cheerful and pleasant. And it has to be clean and also well lit and also well ventilated and also indoor spaces also should be there. Providing an assuring environment. Many children, when they first come into a center, normally they feel very nervous and afraid because they are very new to the place. So some experience separation and scarcity also, especially if it is their first time. So at such a facility, or if they have been away from the setting for a certain period. So as the physical environment plays a very important role in the experiences of a child, the environment of the child care or education facility must be one of the comfort and safety for a start. So when you have enough facilities and also the comfort and when they have safety, it's a very good and can start a good education. So this must be complemented by caregivers or early childhood educators, who can assure the children and settle them in. So when it comes to the child caregiver and givers and early childhood educators play several roles pertaining to this matter. If you take ensuring safe environment, keeping the environment tidy and hygienic, creating a comfortable environment, organizing spaces. Let's talk about the general requirements. Young children should be placed at the ground level to facilitate easy entry and also for safety reason, because as they are little kids, you have to see whether these are in this way, as I said to you. So soundproof walls and ceiling are highly advisable for noise reduction. Also carpets, drapers and other fireproof fabrics can help in sound absorptions. The floors actually should be non-slip. it should, I mean, it, if not carpeted actually, and also a durable, sanitary and easy clean carpets and rugs should be vacuumed daily. I mean, it should be cleaned daily. Okay, let's talk about the preparing the classroom as the indoor environment. To enhance the indoor learning environment, the most important consideration should be its feasibility for infants like toddlers and preschoolers. I mean, to learn through a play, also accordance with the developmental stages of the child. So naturally, the physical environment for babies, toddlers and preschoolers would have significant differences. In early child care centers, typically, I mean, like, there are specific area either for utilization of the children or caregivers facilities. Each area is prepared to, I mean, like, to for the best interest of children's care and education, and also supporting the caregivers to achieve this aim. So apart from that, the other thing that the need to be taken into account are, for example, food served. Also materials and equipments in the center, and artistic or comestic outlook of the center. It should be there, like to attract, like then the kids would like, I mean, like they will enjoy. Oh well, let's look at interest areas. Oh well, identify the interest areas to be included the facility and the type of space that is needed. I mean, like according to it, you have to provide facilities as well as the space also according to the interest areas. Let's look at some example, like, you know, art. When it comes to art, also the blocks, so there should be also a dramatic play, or it's a house corner. They should have a library, that is a literary center, to manipulate, okay, table toys, such as sometimes you would do science discovery, also sand and water, for that also they should have a good separate place. Also the music and movement, and also then again computers, like, to manipulate. A few take about the language area. Actually, the babies are able to understand a great deal of what they hear by the end of the first year. I mean, in the second year, like, they learn to use the words they heard to express their thoughts and feelings and ideas. Like, once they have heard them, in the second year, what they will try is, actually, they will try to express, I mean, like, their thoughts and, like, you know, with their feelings and their ideas and everything, they will try to express them. So therefore, an infant and a toddler care education program should be encouraged the development of language skills, as adults speak and listen to children. A language activity area can provide additional stimulus for language development. So it's really good, like, if you can provide additional stimulus, that is for the language development. Let's talk about the bathrooms, right? Actually, the bathroom should be adjacent to the play and sleeping area and easily reached from outdoors. I mean, like, it's preferable install child-sized toilets and wash basins. If this is not possible, there is a step or platform, I mean, like, to children to access the facilities. I mean, in most early childhood facility setting, the bathroom are without doors. I mean, like, the reason is, like, you know, the teachers or the supervisors or office assistant, I mean, like, they can go and help them whenever necessary, like, to assist the kids. Nap room, I mean, like, some school or care centers provide an area for nap time for the children. This area at CLU, it should be need to be substantial size to cater for cots or bedding. It's accordingly we have to facilitate, like, to the kids. If you talk about the food service, actually, early childhood classrooms are becoming more diverse and multicultural. So therefore, like, routines and food choice as well as toys and materials must be taken into consideration. To their cultural practices and preferences, actually, since this is a multicultural. Let's talk about the wall displays. When it comes to wall displays, children respond very well to visual stimuli. such as wall displays around the facility would not be not only improve the environment, also I mean like the it serve the educational purposes also, like then the kids will look at those posters and they will try to identify, like you know they try to understand something kind of. Okay, children with special needs. When you have some special needs students, children with special needs actually will be benefited from being mainstream into regular child development programs. Like, you know, part-time participation will benefit these children, although some working parents may need all-day care. Oh well, a quality program also can provide this the kind of activities. I mean, the children need to optimize their development. Let's talk about materials and equipment. Like, you know, materials is based on a number of criteria. I mean, like you can say material selector should be suitable for children to use and play with. I mean, when you are providing them, when we are selecting them, we should know whether this is suitable for this age child. And the materials and culture artifacts help a child feel that the environment is familiar and also very comfortable for them. If I talk about the outdoor learning environment, actually a well-planned outdoor space for children offers many possibilities and benefits. Actually, an outdoor environment enables children to experience nature and all its offering of the open space, wildlife, and different landscapes such as hills, holes, streams, and muds and mud puddles. Actually, it is according to Greenman in 1991. Yerkes in 1982, research has shown that children who play outdoors demonstrate better visual motor integration, imagination, and verbal and social skills compared to children who play predominantly indoors. A natural outdoor environment has actually three basic qualities, I mean, that are unique and appealing to children as an environment for play. If you take that an unreading diversity, a natural environment with no adult intervention, a feeling of timelessness, and space where landscapes, I mean, trees, rivers that are described in fairy tales and myths still exist today. So natural settings offer qualities of openness, diversity, and also the manipulation, and also exploration, anonymity, and the wildness. Oh, that's all for this topic. Hope you enjoy this, and good luck with your studies, and thank you.